What's going on with all my billionaires out there? This the guy, Hoods Billionaire. Welcome to Hoods Billionaire TV. Big favor, big abundance. On today's episode, we're going to be talking about District Attorney Fannie Willis say it's more RICO cases on the way against more rappers and more alleged street gangs. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about it. So in a press conference, Fannie Willis let it be known that within the next 60 days, there's going to be two more big RICOs that are going to be coming for prominent rappers that are attached to street gangs in these Atlanta streets. So what do I think about that? Number one, I think that this woman is trying to build a career path and trying to gain footing in her career path, which, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. This is the career and path that she chose. She pretty much is going after the big fish, and she had to take that next step and clean up her section first. She had to clean up Atlanta, which I'm sure she was getting a lot. See, I don't know how, once again, I know how these YouTube streets are. Like, I try to give y'all as close to reality as possible. Like, I don't know how y'all think this shit go, but that woman probably received heavy pressure from multi-millionaire, probably hundreds of millions. You know, it's a lot of money in Atlanta, but there are a lot of business owners and a lot of affluent people who probably put a lot of pressure on this woman to make these to bring these cases to fruition. You see what I'm saying? The crime was running rampant in Atlanta. I mean, basically, from all the reports from Atlanta, Atlanta is hot. It is super hot. It's super hot with criminal activity. I mean, and the people in Atlanta, you know, these good black folks that are rich and are taxpayers, they have say so. I'm trying to tell y'all how this shit really, it's the people that got the money that own the businesses that are really calling the shots. So if these street gangs out here robbing people and doing all this shit, and you see what I'm saying, and running in people's house, home invasions, breaking in cars, killing all it, they're going to put, especially when everybody thinks they know who is behind it or who's responsible, they're going to put that on her and say, hey, we need you to, you know, you got to do something about this. You know what I'm saying? This is affecting my business. So this woman is doing what her job entails based on the pressure that's being put on her. Now, me personally, I don't like seeing nobody in jail, because jail just isn't a good place. I believe we need like some type of mental reform programs. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of shit be like, you know, a lot of these guys are growing up in neighborhoods that don't have a lot of resources, and it kind of funnels them into the streets and the street activity. And if I don't have a lot of resources and my home is broken and I go outside and the niggas outside are showing me love and saying, hey, man, come ride with me. You know, we can get some money this way or that way or this way. You know, that sense of brotherhood, that sense of family, that sense of, you know, of feeling connected to something is what be making kids want to even jump in the streets and jump in the gang. So, you know, I just feel like that's that situation. But nonetheless, she say it's two more RICOs coming out in the next 60 days. So if I'm an Atlanta rapper and I know I got some ties to the streets, I don't got to say no names. You know what I'm saying? Y'all know who the street rappers are in Atlanta. Y'all know who the niggas that's really moving like that and have moved to Atlanta and might have set up base in Atlanta. You feel what I'm saying? If you in the streets, and you know you in the street, you know this, you better clean all your shit up right now. Like, the thug situation, I hope, you know, at least got this next wave of rappers prepared. Shouldn't be no guns at your house. Shouldn't be no drugs at your house. Y'all shouldn't be talking on no phones. Y'all shouldn't be talking on no jail phones. Y'all shouldn't be communicating with nobody. The big dog, whoever the big dog is, definitely shouldn't be communicating with nobody. Definitely shouldn't be around nothing or around nobody. Y'all boys need to clear all that shit out, get y'all lawyers together, get everything as tight as possible, and just be more prepared for when the wave hits And if it's not you, then hey, at least you got everything cleaned up and you conducting your business in a better manner. You know what I'm saying? But if it is you, you know, that's just less evidence that they can stick on you. You know, from the thug Rico, and it's like he possibly, it's a lot of codees in that indictment. It's a lot of codees in that indictment, but I still don't think thug would be as bad off if they didn't find all them guns and shit in his house. You see what I'm saying? Like in his possession, like that's gonna be ugly. You feel what I'm saying? So y'all clean that shit up. But it's just Atlanta in general, man. You know what I'm saying? Y'all gotta, you know, just tighten up a little bit, man. You know, get them streets under control. It can be a balance, bro. Like if you choose to be a street nigga, like that's your choice. You know what I'm saying? But it gotta be a balance with the just regular good people who want to live in Atlanta and thrive and have good lives. It gotta be a balance. You see what I'm saying? So she say it's 2 more indictments coming, so they'll be here in the next 60 days, man. And like I say, I'm just, you know, praying for everybody involved. We're gonna send out positive vibrations to everybody. You know what I'm saying? And maybe this will be a wake up call. You know what I'm saying? For all my street niggas out there that, you know what I'm saying, are on that type of time. I want y'all to really evaluate y'all's situation and say, man, is this really worth it? Think about something that you really good at. Think about something that you can monetize and that you could do legally and say, man, I can get money this way. I can do this. You know what I'm saying? Instead of putting my life and my freedom at risk all the time. Maybe just some food for thought. But man, y'all let me know what y'all think, man. What rappers y'all think possibly could be in for this Rico? You know what I'm saying? Y'all let me know. You know, or do y'all think it might just be some regular street gang shit and it might not even be no rappers involved? Y'all let me know in the comments. Just the Godhoods be in there. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Like, share, subscribe. This the Godhoods be in there. Big favor, big abundance. And before I forget, I do have to say this. I actually looked this case up. I saw this on DJ Academics channel. And I looked it up myself. This lady is after Donald Trump for his role in trying to alter the results of the 2020 election where Biden won. Like this lady sending out, you know, statement letters to high-end Republicans letting them know that, you know, they're probably going to be indicted to come testify and speak on what happened. So she not playing with nobody. She on Trump ass, she on thug ass, she on Gunna ass, she on Hood Rich Pablo Wine ass, she on YFN Luke. This lady is playing for her all across the board, straight across. Nigga, if you going after Trump and Young Thug, that ain't, you know what I'm saying? That lady doing her job, and she feel like if she do a good job, that's going to help her career path. It is what it is, man. It's the Godhoods be in there. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, man. Hey, and the Cash App giveaway. Y'all look at my Cash App giveaway video, man. We doing the Cash App video, the Cash App giveaway. Check out the video. Check out the video. Check out the instructions. Subscribe to the channel. You know, we Cash Apping free money, man. August 14th. This the Godhoods be in there. Big favor, big abundance. I'm gone.